Okay, kids, I'm gonna show you today how we can use Pivot Interactives to create a video that will help us to measure data for calculating the speed of an object. So our job on this current lab is to figure out some object that we want to calculate the speed of it. You want to pick something that you can get to be fairly constant speed. We don't want something that's really speeding up or really slowing down, something that you can see that is a constant speed. For me, I am going to use this ball. I'm going to roll a ball at a constant speed and try to figure out how fast it's going. Now, in order for us to do that on the video, we need to have what is called a frame of reference. A frame of reference is some object that you know its exact length. Okay, and so we have a couple of different options here for you. If you have a ruler at home, you could put a ruler in the video. So that's what I got right there, is a ruler. Most rulers are a 12-inch ruler. And so if you have that in your video, you can use that as your frame of reference. If you have a tape measure, you could use tape measures. You would simply need to know how long the tape measure is or how much of the tape measure is showing, and know that length. I also will have for you a digital ruler that you will print out. That's what this one is right here. That is a 12-inch digital ruler. And you could use that then as your frame of reference. If for whatever reason you don't want to print out that ruler, or you've got a printer that's not working, or don't have a printer, or whatever, as long as you have some paper, you could use paper for your frame of reference. Standard printer paper is 8.5 inches wide. So you know that it is 8.5 inches. That could be your frame of reference. Or if you have just a regular sheet of notebook paper, you can tear that out of your notebook and get rid of those frilly edges. And if you do that, that is exactly 8 inches wide. So you could use that as your frame of reference also. So in your video, you would have to have a piece of paper somehow showing, and you'd have to have your object rolling past it. So for again example, if I got this ball, I want to try to roll it at a constant speed. So I do that. Obviously you don't want it to grab a ruler, but that gives you the idea. Okay, so that's what you need. On our next video, I will show you how we will use this video, how we will upload it to Pivot Interactives, and how we will allow Pivot Interactives to calibrate for your distances. Okay, so that'll be our next video.